It's full throttle, lights out, and we are going. Spielberg, superb start from pole position once again by Pekka Banyaiks. Now they just did in the sprint yesterday. Really good start as well by Luca Marini. He's up beside P3, although he nearly lost the rear. Big moment for the number 10. That's going to break up the field. But it's Banyaiks and Bindaclia.
Vinales got away better that time, but he just got completely beaten up into the first corner. Alex Marquez came up the inside of him, and Vinales had to check up. Look how far back he is. He's behind Bastianini and his teammate.
Absolute disaster for Maverick Vinales. And top of the hill in the turn number three. Vinales down 11th place through the first sector. Close there between Marquez and Marini. Marini got a really good launch off the line. From 6th to 3rd in the first corner, we had a big, big scare. Lit up that rear tyre on the exit. He was pretty fortunate on the high side there.
Well, whatever Ducati found on the start system, it's clearly working a treat, isn't it? Because Pecco Bagnaia is clear of the KTMs. Brad Binder and Jack Miller, second and third. Then it's Alex Marquez with his battle with the Mooney VR46 Ducatis of Marini and Bezzecchi. Fabio Quartararo is seventh. And Jorge Martin, with that long lap penalty to come, is up four into eighth.
Vinales trying to recover from another poor start. He has got through on his teammate, Aleix Espargaró, halfway round this opening lap of 28 here in Austria.
It was a really tough second lap for Fabio Quartararo. He lost four places. We saw the move from Vinales at the start of the lap. Aleix Espargaró, Enea Bastianini and Joan Zarco also made their way through on the number 20. So Quartararo in early difficulties as Jack Miller looks set to soon relinquish third place. Very late on the brakes there into turn one, wasn't he? And Jorge Martin does take the long lap penalty loop, which he had problems with this morning. As he comes through it this time, he's safely through.
Pace hotting up at the front, no question. Bagnaia and Binder, they break into the 129s for the first time. The only two riders out on circuit in those 129s. They're already making that decisive break. In terms of the spectacle, though, it's all down on Binder to try and keep par with Bagnaia at the early part of this race. Miller, Marquez, Marini, Bezzecchi are all in the sort of low to mid 130s. Bagnaia and Binder with by far the superior speed early on as Quartararo runs wide through turn number nine.
Yeah, so that's where he lost all that time then at the end of the second lap, and you'll see Bastianini just easing through, and Zarco too taking places from Quartararo. He's running around at the moment in 11th place, promoted up a spot by Jorge Martin. So that long lap penalty completely erased all that progress that Martin made on the first two laps.
Has Binder got the drive going through the corner grip, coming through turn number eight? He was thinking about a lunge on the inside of Bagnaia there, wasn't he? Down into that third gear, turn number nine. But Bagnaia just too good himself on the front end of that Ducati. And Pekka Bagnaia will know at the back of his mind as he sees on his pit board, sees on the lap counter, Binder plus 0.1. He will know at some point that Binder's going to have some potential issues and concerns about front tyre pressure, front tyre temperature. It's imperative Bagnaia knows that he's got to keep the South African behind him.
Alex Marquez through then on Jack Miller up into third place, and you can see the Mooney VR46 Ducatis are now queuing up behind Jack Miller. This is kind of a familiar feeling, isn't it, for the Australian? We've seen it in recent Grand Prix. He's able to get up front in qualifying and get a good start, but then he ends up reversing back down the field, and that looks like the fate for the Australian at the moment.
Yeah, Marquez has gapped him straight away. This was the move, the classic move. You get the drive through turn number eight as they come over the crest. The blind run down towards the third gear, 120 kilometres an hour, turn number nine. Yeah, Jorge Martin with the long lap excursion on that previous lap. His time was a 33.6. So compared to your race leader, Pecco Bagnaia, how much was the damage? Well, it was well over 3 seconds. That's how costly yesterday's first corner controversy was for Jorge Martin. Alex Marquez, having got through on Jack Miller, is getting on with this, isn't he? 130.222, best lap of his race so far, as Bezzecchi finds a way through now.
And Marini.
Yeah, and Marini. So Jack Miller, unfortunately, going the wrong way once again, just hasn't got the speed that he has at the start of these Grand Prix to keep the momentum going.
And next up behind Miller will be the two factory Aprilias of Maverick Vinales and Aleix Espargaró. Bezzecchi once again was the fastest rider on circuit. He did a 130.3, a tenth of a second quicker than the leader is going. So we've got an all Ducati battle at the moment for third place, the 73 against the 72.
Yeah, potential first dry Grand Prix podium on a Ducati here for Alex Marquez, as Maverick Vinales then finally does find safe passage through on Miller. So Vinales then up into P6. Alex Marquez living up to top billing again here, but this is going to be a big ask, trying to keep Marco Bezzecchi behind him for a good 12 or 13 laps.
Yeah, Benteke, as you see at the moment, would be 9 points behind Jorge Martin. That's the battle for second in the World Championship. He's come from a long way back here as Marco Benteke. Is he going to get that? Ciccati stopped. Unsurprisingly, he didn't.
Not a hope in hell of getting that one stopped. You could see that one was not going to happen when we rode on board with him. He had to run off. Alex Marquez would have seen him on the inside, just made sure that he wasn't going to turn in and there was going to be any contact between the pair of them. Raul Fernandez further down the field. He's way outside the points in 19th. A big struggle for the Crypto Data RNF man. He's got a track limits warning as well. So has the likes of Ike Lekuona and Fabio the John Antonio. None of that trio currently circulating in the point scoring places. This was the attempted and ultimately unsuccessful overtake that Marco Bezzecchi launched on Alex Marquez going into the first corner.
Yeah, Alex Marquez will be more than grateful to take that third place back again, doing a fine job, isn't he? Just 2 seconds behind Brad Binder in second place and doing very comparable lap times to the South African up ahead. You could see just behind Bezzecchi, the second Mooney VR46 Ducati of Luca Marini. He did a 130.8 last time around, so he's holding a pretty safe and secure fifth place. Here he is on the number 10. He had a good outing here last year as well, didn't he, when he finished in fourth. That was a career best at the time for Luca Marini, and at the moment he's not under any threat from behind with Vinales here on screen a couple of seconds adrift.
We're on board now then with Bezzecchi. He's tried this move once before. He's closer this time around on Alex Marquez. Can he pull it up to the apex? He's going in wide again and they almost touch on the exit. Alex Marquez had the line. Bezzecchi just had to check up. So that's two times he's tried into turn one, Alex Marquez. Both have been unsuccessful raids. Yeah, here comes Bezzecchi, just got the better grip, the better edge grip and the drive through turn number eight. And this time around, he doesn't need to wait to turn one to make his move on Alex Marquez. Alex Marquez then now in a Mooney VR 46 Ducati sandwich. Has he got anything in terms of retaliation against Bezzecchi now with that clear track in front of him?
Alex Marquez is about to lose fourth place, although he's fighting back as Valentino Rossi cheers his half-brother on. Alex Marquez says, not just yet, Luca.
Marquez versus the Rossi family. Yes. We've seen that a few times, haven't we, down the years? We're not going to dig up old rivalries.
Moving on.
We'll leave it to the current stars, the current generation. Marini then briefly through on the Grazini Ducati. You feel now, though, that even if he is able to find a way through, the podium's gone because Marco Bezzecchi has streaked away in convincing fashion here. The gap between Bezzecchi and Marquez is 1.7 seconds. And Marini also now finds a way through. Just got the better edge grip, the better acceleration grip coming out of turn 10. Didn't he need to wait to have a risky move on Marquez up the hill into turn one, did he? So Bezzecchi and Marini keeping the boss very, very happy. He's loving his life in the Austrian sunshine, is Valentino Rossi, because now his boys P3 and P4.
Pekka Maniaia has made it very clear today, hasn't he, at the benchmark that they need to reach. Paul Espargaro has now also been given a long lap penalty, presumably for the same thing. He'd also received a track limits warning. That's likely to cost him a World Championship point to his teammate Augusto Fernandez.
So we're on board then with Brad Binder. The KTM fans are on their feet. The Orange Army, as they always are here in the Red Bull Ring in Austria, out in force. They'd have been hoping that this man could have repeated his heroics of 2021, but unfortunately, he is not going to do so because of this man's brilliance, this man's genius. We're on the last lap then here in the Crypto Data Grand Prix of Austria, and the data in the record books will show a convincing and commanding win for factory Ducati star Pekka Bagnaia. He starts this final lap 5.5 seconds clear of Binder. Safe second, a lonely second for the South African. Likewise, in turn, it's going to be a lonely third place for Marco Bezzecchi. Would it have been a different story for him, all this Butts, Watson, maybes, of course, had he not started seventh and then had to work so hard and spend so long to get through on the hard-charging Alex Marquez. But it looked like after his sprint disappointment, there's a podium on offer here for Bez.
If you're on the lookout for some late drama, your best bet is probably for fifth and sixth. Alex Marquez is continuing to lose time to Maverick Vinales, who's another rider who will look back on this weekend as a what might have been. Through the first sector, Vinales has been able to close that gap to under a second, but unless we get a late mistake from Marquez, Vinales might have to settle for sixth place.
Davide Tardozzi looking rather pensive with the fingers crossed. He's got no need to worry. No problemo whatsoever for the number one. The epitome of cool and composed. This has been one of the most dominant performances of Pekka Bagnaia's Grand Prix career. It's a half century, 50 career podiums coming up then for Pecco Bagnaia. Utter domination. Ducati reigns supreme once again here at the Red Bull Ring in Spielberg. Q more jubilant celebrations inside the factory Ducati garage. Pecco Bagnaia wins by a mile, 5.1 seconds ahead of Brad Binder. Another home podium for KTM, celebrating his new two-year contract. Marco Bezzecchi does take a very challenging third place. Marini fourth, Valentino Rossi watching from the sidelines. He'll be really happy with his boys, third and fourth.
But the beautiful trophy of the circuit layout here, and it is a circuit that was owned this weekend by Pecco Bagnaia.